Hello all, I welcome you to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to install Dev C++ on a Windows operating system. So, let's begin. Now to install Dev C++, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser. And in the address bar, you need to just simply search with Dev C++ space download and hit enter. And we'll get the sourceforge.net as our first search result. So here you need to just simply click on this Dev C++ download, and it's going to redirect to the official site of SourceForge.net. So here if you just simply scroll down, you can see that we have Dev C++ is available to download, and here is our download button. So just simply click on this link and it's going to start downloading our Dev C++ in 5 seconds. So you can see it has rightly started downloading our Dev C++ 5.11 version. So let's wait for a couple of minutes, and you can see it is rightly downloaded. So just simply click on this installer. And it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes. And let's minimize our browser. So here you can see that our setup is currently, you know, unpacking the data, and it's going to launch our installation wizard. So here you can see it is asking to select a language. So English is fine, or if you want to change your language, you can do that by just simply this from this drop down. I'll keep this default. I'll just simply click on OK. And this is our license agreement. Place to, you know, read the license agreement and click on I agree. So here it's going to install all these files. So here the most important thing is this TDM GCC compiler. So it's going to install along with the IDE this compiler as well. So everything is fine. Just simply click on next. So see, it's ready to be installed. Just simply click on install, and there we go. It has rightly started installing our Dev C++. So once our Dev C++ gets installed, you need to just simply click on finish. So you can see that our Dev C++ is also installed, and here is our desktop shortcut, and it has rightly launched over here as well. So as you know, English is our, you know, default language, which is selected. Just simply click on next. And here the default font is Consolas it has selected. So if you want to change that, you can always do that from this drop down. If you want to change this font, this color is currently selected as Classic Plus. Again, if you want to change that, you can do that from this drop down. So let's say you want to choose Visual Studio, it is going to change the font, the color as per Visual Studio. You know, I'll go back to the classic font, and this icon is like this. This icon also, if you want to change, you can choose from this drop down, right? I'm going to, you know, keep all this default. Click on next, and it has configured successfully. Just simply click on OK, and there you go. You can see that our Dev C++ is rightly launched. So this is the interface of our Dev C++, and here you can see that we have this compiler TDM GCC 4.9.2. So this is a compiler. It is a very important thing. So this will actually help you to, you know, interpret the code. So it will help you to compile. So that's why it is very important to have the compiler, and Dev C++ is the IDE where you write the code. So let's, you know, create a new file, new source file, and here I'm going to write a simple C++ program. So first I'm going to, you know, go to file and click on save as, and I'm going to save this file as, you know, hello.c program. So I'll just, you know, simply give .c, and I'll just click on save, and you can see it has rightly saved as hello.c. So here you can write simple hello world program. So hash include stdio.h, then int main, and I'm going to, you know, simply open the parenthesis, and I'm going to print hello world, right? Hello world. So if you face any difficulty to read this code, you can just simply go to tools and click on this editor option. And here, if you just simply go to font and increase the size, so I'll increase it to something big, like 24 maybe. Click on OK, and you can see that font is like quite big. So I hope you have no problem in reading the code now. So I'll just simply return 0. So since I have declared this main method as int, so it will expect to, you know, get something in return as integer. So that's why I'm returning 0 over here. So as include stdio.h int main printf hello world. So just simply write this much and go to file and click on save, right? And after saving this, you need to just simply click on this run button, and what it will do is it will going to first compile our project. So just simply click on yes, and once our compile gets successful, you can see that it throws some error. That is, you know, I have missed a semicolon here, so that's why that error. So just again click on this run button, so it's going to again compile our code, and then it's going to, you know, show you the console. So here is our console. So in this console, you can see this output hello world is rightly shown over here, right? So in this way, you can easily install the latest version of Dev C++ on the Windows operating system. I have also shown you how you can easily write a simple hello world program in C and how you can easily run that on our Dev C++. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please do like, share and subscribe. That will really help me to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.